Well, good morning. This is what we're looking at on the deck. The wind blowing and drifting and stuff. You can see it around that bucket there, how it drifted in. And then over here, you can see where a whole bunch of it is just blown off the side of the table there. But yeah, this is what the deck is looking like. Those rails are 6 inches up. So, you know, you can see where the wind is blowing through a little bit. And there's that. All the hoods of the vehicles in the carports there, they're all covered with snow. I'll get better pictures of this as I move around here. Yep, this is what we're looking at this morning. All right. And this is where we're at on the other side of the deck there, where you've got a little bit of wind, or it's out of the wind a little bit. But yeah, there's a few inches of snow. All right, this is some of the snow toys there. I don't normally show the shovels and stuff or the scrapers because I rarely use them. But this is what we're going to use to clean the first part of the deck there where the snow is light there underneath there where all the stuff is. But this is the rest of the snow. So don't worry, I'm not going to break too big of a sweat moving snow. And then I'll get some pictures of the other stuff out there as we get going. I was out this morning and had to shovel a place for my wood ashes and stuff. This doesn't like to move heavier snow, so we'll get some of it. We'll get going here. Deck is. So that's the basic part of that with the deck. Now to get this thing off. I never wear this with this many clothes on. It's usually just a t-shirt. So that's how that's done. Now for the other part. My little electric snowblower, deck blower. Guess I ain't gonna turn that. So, this is what I use on the deck. So much for the deck. Yeah, if you look down there, you can see their door where they can come and go as they please. All right. Now, we'll get the big gun out. Goes right through. That over there is the wood stove. The wood cart got some wood on it. Everything a minute or two to get the temperature. But we got a good amount of frost in the driveway, so I can use the cutting edge on this rather than having to push backwards all the time. But yeah, this is what we got. scraping out some of the walkways and stuff here. Getting her stuff cleaned out a little bit. Running this with one hand. I was going to put the magnet mount on this. This will be all right. Like I said, the driveway's got frost in it now, so we can use the cutting edge on it. The steel is still warm, so the snow is sticking just a little bit. Does a pretty good job. At least I don't sweat any. I used to have to pull that little wagon all the way around here. That was hard, especially if there was any snow in it. Woodshed. I got the neighbor's rototiller sitting in there. I stole that last summer and didn't give it back to him. Got a load of fire pit wood in there on the wagon, and then the rest of it is all firewood for the house. This is what the backside of the shed looks like. So she's pulled right to the rafters all the way. be a project there this summer in June there in between Eureka Springs and Laconia. Do a little extra work there, cut up some firewood there in the middle of stuff there. We'll see how that all works out. So here I put the bucket right down pretty good for a cutting edge. I've got pavement under all this. The stuff that I brought in that was waste material and worked real well. Alright, so that's basically what I got. I get on the main part of the driveway there. I'll start this up again and we'll do some more with it. I just got to clean all this up, clean out the upper part of this driveway, and then I got to go do the other driveway. This is what we've got. Okay, I got the front pretty well cleaned out. Everything is out about. I got to go over and do the other driveway. It goes out around the back of the pond there. Okay, I'm getting ready to do the driveway up here. Goes up through the trees here, so let's see what we can do here. There, where the snowplow pushes stuff up. It's only a little 6-foot scraper blade. It used to be years ago, I only had a little bitty 4-foot box blade that I used on it. This is, of course, new tractor and everything else with it. I've looked at getting a newer tractor with a cab on it, heat and air conditioning and everything. Replace this, but to use instead of this. This is all set up for my backhoe, so I can't get rid of it, but no, a new one has been $52,000. I don't think I want to do that. I can put snowshoes on yet, but I thought with the new one I could put a radio in it, and if I got a problem or anything I could just call up Joanne and have her come out and use broomstick or whatever and unplug the damn screwed on the blower. If I needed to use the blower, got it plugged. So she didn't think that was a good idea, but I thought it was a great idea. That is our well. It's an artesian well. It's got gas in it though. And over here on the left, I've got a 300 gallon beer ball sitting in the ground there for a settling tank. So the gas runs off of that. Then out of that, the water comes into the house where all the gas has been released. here and we'll do the main driveway that goes around the back of the pond. Look at all my camera lenses. They're all nice and clean. There's no snow on them. So we've had a lot of people breaking in and shit, doing all kinds of stuff. But all my cameras there trigger an alarm, and I keep a 45 by the bed. So it would be a good thing to get caught here. Where we come around there, this is a long driveway going out. We're moving a fair amount of snow right now. This stuff is better than 8 inches or so deep in here because it's so thin. It just settles in here. I don't know, I may put the snow blower on, we'll see. So that's that. I gotta finish unloading what little bit of wood is on the wood wagon in there, and then I'll just drag that right outside rather than going in to get it. And then we'll go over and get some wood. So all I gotta do now is pick this up, take it over there to the woodshed there, fill it up with wood, and we're off and running. Today is Monday afternoon, Monday evening. Went out and hooked up the snowblower. We're supposed to get 4 to 6 inches of snow tomorrow, between tomorrow and tomorrow night. So it's gonna be a lot easier just to move that much snow with the snowblower, because then I could just move it one time. I ain't gotta deal with it. But this has been sitting out there in the driveway. You can see it in one of the other videos. So anyway, it's all set up, ready to go. We'll see what kind of mischief we can get into tomorrow with it. Okay, see ya. All right, this is the snowblower. This is what it looks like.